My name is Joelle Abirashid. I'm a second year postdoctoral fellow at Columbia University's Society of Fellows in the Humanities. I'm also a lecturer at the Department of Middle East, South Asia and African Studies. I also hold a secondary affiliation with the History Department. Before coming to Columbia, I was originally trained as a medical doctor at the American University of Beirut. And back then, I was intrigued by the other dimensions of medicine that are not usually taught in medical school. At least I wasn't taught these other dimensions that have to do with politics, with social dimensions of medicine, with the ethical dimensions, with the economic dimensions of medicine and medical power and medical knowledge. So I ended up doing a master's in philosophy and public policy at the London School of Economics. And more recently, I graduated from Harvard University with a PhD in history of science. I'm currently working on my book project, which is about the history of war, madness, and modernity in the modern Middle East, and which draws heavily on my dissertation. And by modern Middle East, I mean the Middle East as we know it today. The book explores the complex relationship between pathology and normality. It also explores the emergence of psychiatric practice and thinking, its diffusion, its institutionalization, its disciplinization, so to speak. It also looks at the ways in which madness, mental illness, and even deviance, more broadly speaking, were defined, articulated, and even acted upon, managed, and controlled. And I examine all these issues by reconstituting and critically analyzing the historical development of one of the first psychiatric hospitals in the region, which was known as Asfuriye, which in Arabic means the place of the birds. And you can imagine this place with goldfinches. The picture is very telling because of it shows the architecture of the place. This was known as the cottage system, which supposedly gave a homey atmosphere. And was supposedly part of the therapeutic approach and therapeutic philosophy of the hospital. Now, the hospital was founded in 1896, and I use the genealogy of the birth of psychiatry in the region as a way to illuminate questions that have to do with social policy, with norms and values, with the complex relationship between secular and religious power, with a complex and often fraught relationship between empire and missions, and with issues that have to do with, I said already, modernity, but also medicalization. This is an Ottoman map of 1893, and you can see on this map, the red area is actually Mount Lebanon, so this semi-autonomous enclave in the Ottoman Empire where the hospital was located. But this was quite an open area, and patients came from all over, from Alexandria, to Latakia in northern Syria. The role of Asfuriye, of the hospital, changed dramatically over the years from being a missionary endeavor, a refuge for the downtrodden, the poorest of the poor, the poor lunatics that were the target of missionaries, to becoming a national institution and finally a regional institution with tremendous sociopolitical power. And this is another picture where you can see patients with the British matron. And you can also see the female attendants or nurses who were trained by the British matron and who were drawn from the local population. And the little known fact is that many psychiatrists, many psychologists, many social workers, and even psychiatric nurses were trained at Asfuriye and ended up shaping mental health policies in many Arab countries, be it in Iraq, in Palestine, or even in Saudi Arabia. The book also shows how war played a key sociopolitical role in shaping the fate of psychiatry in the region. So on the one hand, it enabled the flourishing of psychiatry in the region, which may sound paradoxical and ironic. And on the other hand, it allowed or catalyzed the politics and politicization of health. In other words, health became a commodity that could now be monopolized by various stakeholders. I taught last year an undergraduate seminar which looked at the politics of health from the era of colonialism to the age of globalization. It was an interdisciplinary seminar and with a special focus on Africa, the Middle East, and Southeast Asia. In that seminar, we explored issues such as race, such as subjectivity, such as modernity, imperial ambitions, local agency, through the lens of medical hospitals, medical diseases, public health policies, epidemics, and so on. As the product of three types of educational systems, French, American, and British, and the product of many disciplinary traditions, I value a rigorous discipline of the mind, conceptually, methodologically, and theoretically. I also value experimentalism and plasticity. Now, when I do ask my students to work on a certain project, I want them to combine both digital archives with their use of their foreign language skills and therefore the use of primary sources that are written in foreign languages. I try to instill in my students critical analytical skills and make them critical of the present, not only to appreciate the past, but in fact to imagine the future and imagine better futures. And as a historian of science and medicine, I try to show them how medicine and science is actually the product of politics, of societal norms and values, of culture. Finally, I try to inculcate in my students an openness towards the other so that they can be prepared to be the visionary global citizens, well-rounded intellectuals of tomorrow that we all hope they would become.